Hey everyone, Steve here. Before I start the video on how to create a POAP, I want to let everyone know that I'm giving away these POAP NFC cards. So what they are essentially is you can load up any POAP you want onto these cards. And when tapped with a phone, like on the back, what you can see is a notification. When tapped on it, it'll automatically open up your POAP app and start minting the POAP on the card. So it's great for You've Met Me POAPs. If you want to distribute your POAPs that way, it's just like a really user-friendly experience. Instead of scanning QR codes, they can just go tap back of the phone. All you have to do is subscribe to HODL Labs on YouTube and follow HODL Labs on Twitter. And like I said, there's a new winner every month. If you do it now, you're in the run for the whole year. So one a month until the rest of the year. Good luck, everyone, and I'll start the video now. Hey, everyone. Steve here from HODL Labs. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create a POAP in 2023. This is the new updated POAP platform called drops.poap.xyz. This overhauls the old system and it makes it really, really easy to create a POAP now. So what you want to do first, obviously go to drops.poap.xyz. Either sign in with your email. If you have Google, click on Google. I'll just do that now. All right, I am in the main menu now. I don't know why my video has stopped, but we're going to rock and roll with it. What we have here is all the drops that this email is associated with. So in the past, if you created a drop, it will pop up in this new dashboard. But for now, we'll just create a new one. So we'll just do test title. I'll just fill out these details, but test title, whatever the title of your POAP wants to be, whatever description you would like to add to it, the website, your drop start and end date, if it's in-personal or if it's virtual. So in-person, you can add your city and your country. Virtual, you click the platform on where your drop is taking place. Public or private, you can keep it public if you want everyone to know about your drop and can see it on the main POAP gallery page. But if you want it to be private just for you, or if you're just doing a test, just keep it on private. So, and this is also where you upload, of course, your artwork. So title, description, artwork, website, they're the main ones. I'll fill it all out and I'll show you. All right, this is just an example here. So I've just done a POAP for my friend. Obviously, he's already created this POAP. I'm just recreating this as an example as a test, but we've got the artwork here. We've got the title. We've got a bit of a description, can add a lot more to it, make it a lot more sentimental. And then we've got the website that everyone wants to link to. Once they collect the POAP, we've got the start and the end date of the event, virtual, in-person, Brisbane, Australia, public. Once we're happy with that, we'll click create POAP. Okay, so once you've clicked create, you'll be brought to this screen here. So you haven't actually been approved by POAP to have this POAP for your event. What we do now is petition to POAP by selecting the method on where how we want to distribute our POAP. So the distribution methods here, we've got a few to pick from. We've got four. I'll go through each one and how they are different to each other. So mint links here, these are a big list of unique URLs. No URL is the same. They all have their own little code at the end of them. Each individual mint links leads to your POAP to redeem. So this prevents people leaking a URL between people that didn't attend your event. So that's a very, very common way to distribute your POAP securely. The next option is a secret. So this is essentially like a password. So if you want an audience to redeem your POAP, and you can't distribute via mint links, you can give them all a password. You can pretty much say your password out loud. They go into the POAP app and then type in the password or the secret word essentially, and they can claim your POAP that way. And then we've got a website, which is, instead of mint links being all unique, this is one static URL. So it is at risk of getting farmed. It's not a preferred method to distribute your POAPs. But it's essentially, like I said, a static URL that anyone can click on, anyone can redeem a POAP. And then we have delivery, which is essentially whitelisting a POAP to a list of Ethereum addresses. So any on-chain activity, this is best for. You just punch in all the Ethereum address that should be claiming the POAP, and then it's a delivery that gets sent out and people can click on your delivery, see if they're eligible to claim the POAP and claim it that way. So mint links is the most common. So I'll go through the setup of that. So say we want 10 mint links and our event starts on the 10th of March. I've set here. So I want it to go for a little bit longer, so maybe 24th. And we want to do submit request. And what we have here is you've submitted it successfully. And what you want to do is fill in the form. So this now gives POAP a better idea on how you want to distribute your POAPs, what is your event, pretty much all the nitty gritty stuff that you don't want to include in your description of your POAP, but you need to kind of relay all the information. All right, so I filled in this information here. I want to celebrate it be on tour. All those that attend my IRL show, I want to give a POAP to. Who's supposed to receive, those that attend my event. We're going to do is send info. So once that's sent, it can take up to 24 hours for POAP to review your petition. What we have here is requested 10, and we will wait for a response from POAP via email. Alrighty, so we've just received an email from POAP saying, hooray, your mint links are here. So this is our event. And what we have here is our mintlinks.txt file. From this, you can distribute each individual link, or you can set up a POAP kiosk, which is this one, by going to kiosk.poap.xyz, create, and then sliding in your mint links. And once you've submitted your mint links, you just want to type in your email address that submitted them or submitted the drop, create dispenser. And what you have here is your public kiosk link. And then down below, we have the admin link. That's the link that you visit to edit your kiosk or delete it. So there is a link down there. I won't show it, but this is the main one that you want to put onto your iPads or your phone to dispense your POAP. So we can go through, type in the public, and there we are. So each time that scans, because the mint links, they're all unique. So each QR code represents a mint link. So someone can take a photo of this, share it online, and will no longer be valid because by that time, the QR code would have gone to the next one. So we can scan that and it'll change. But so that's mint links, that's using a kiosk. We'll go back now and talk about secret word. All right, so that's mint links done. Now onto secret word. So this is the way to distribute your POAP over voice, over a talk, all that kind of thing. So what we wanna do is click on secret. Ideally, you wanna keep that secret that's default. That's quite a hard to guess secret word because essentially anyone that has this can get your POAP. You can change it to something else. But we'll just keep it like that. And we want, say, 20. And the claim window has to be short because, like I said, anyone with that can claim your POAP. It is very leakable between friends, between group chats, all that kind of thing. So what you want to do is set a claim window. So our event is on the 10th, and we actually want people redeeming it on the 11th starting at 1 p.m., and it's going to go for 10 minutes. So 1 p.m. till 1:10 p.m. will be the little window for people to claim it. So you can go up to 30 and then you can go custom, but it's recommended to go 10. And once you're happy with that, you click submit request. And again, what we have here is an email from POAP saying your request has been approved. That's the word there, but we'll go back to the dashboard and have a look what that looks like. And once we refresh the dashboard here, we can see that's our original mint links that we tested with, and now we've got our secret word, and then that's our secret, all pretty good. I won't go into website, like we have that kiosk I showed before, that rotating QR code, that really is superior to having a website. This is just for static printed out pieces of paper, QR codes, where you essentially type in the URL that you want and the amount, and then putting your mint window the same as like a secret word. And then we have delivery, which is copying your title and description of your drop, and then listing all the Ethereum addresses that will get a POAP. And then essentially you get a URL. Sorry, you also type in your URL. You get that URL to send to your group. And if eligible, they will be able to get in to claim a POAP. But secret and mint links are really the two most common ways to distribute your POAP. So I'll just be covering those. And that's about it. If you have any questions, hit me up. I'm always happy to help. One quick thing to add, sorry. So we have here view in gallery. So this is the gallery page that looks a bit like the claim page of your POAP. So what you can see here is your title, description, your artwork, but also as people claim it, you can see it all generating down here. All right, I hope you enjoy that tutorial. That was just a quick run through on the new platform, how to create mint links, how to create secrets, what's their kind of difference. Like, comment, and subscribe. HODL Labs is everything POAP, so we do tutorials on how to create POAPs, how to distribute your POAPs, how to add utility to your POAPs, how to token gate your POAPs to certain platforms. We've got a bunch of video tutorials. Feel free to have a look around. Any questions, let me know. Happy to help. This is my thing. I love it. Tell your friends about it. Make a POAP. Even if it's a test POAP, you haven't got a specific event, make a test POAP. Check it out. Hit me up. Love your work. Let me know. If you have any dramas, catch you later.